Okay, so then I'm like, well, I got an email and it said from a corporation, it said more regulations and rules are being added to their company. So I was like, well, more. And immediately I'm like, there's more regulations and more rules. I don't want to read your email. I don't want to visit your company. It was like a Blade Runner switch moment, you know. It's just like, well, just put your little hypey sign up there on the Tokyo Plaza, and I think people won't even listen or care about your new regulations. We're just inundated with so many of them, you know. And I'm like, well, unfortunately, it's an internet company, and so they're making internet rules, and I don't think it's going to work. So anyway, that was all I had. My observation was internet, was the company says no to me right away, and I'm just like feeling like a Blade Runner, what do you call it, Blade Runner switch, like, do you remember that woman? All that blonde hair, and yeah, she was neat. Well, short hair, it was really short, and then she was like a ninja with her legs, and she did like things in that guy's office. I can't remember the movie, and maybe it was Blade Runner, I don't know. But yeah, it's just like rules. That was exactly what happens. They gave so many rules to the people that they just forget it. Forget it, they became undergrounds and undergrounds and undergrounds. And so it becomes not just mafia world, it was just more and more undergrounds. You know, the underground that does this and the underground that does that. And I think that's all they're gonna do and create. You know? So anyway. Anyway, I'm having fun singing lately. I'm starting to get back in my groove. I have my happiness I'm just loving it, actually. But what is it that the Kalas said, that a singer is not a singer unless there's the trills on the you have to have those trills. I'm not sure my trills are so trilly, but I'm trying. La 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 la. You know. Gosh. Yeah, Blade Runner world and regulations. Yeah, what a faux pas, faux pas. I'm saying all everything wrong. It's not even a faux pas. That was a retrograde thing again that happened to me. Like, today I've been planning, you know, for this landscape. And I'm done. And then I go around the corner, I was testing the irrigation. There was like a new pond in the tubing, and I'm like, that's not even possible. But there was a pond there, so it was a good thing that I checked it and let it run a long time, because then I noticed it seeped up, you know, so you see it. Because it could have been there for a long time and I wouldn't have known. So I found the pond and I fixed it. But yeah, and then just at that time, I'm like, well, this is just, you know, anticlimactic moment of the day. Is this thing is beeping. I can't turn it off. It's some kind of a clock that just forces itself to beep at a certain hour. And anyway, so then I look down at one of the trees that I had just planted. It's just a small tree, but the point was, there was this pit bull, and he had his leg hiked to it, and he was claiming it, And his owner was there, just standing there, going, "Yeah, okay." And so the pit bull claimed the tree, the new tree. He found it immediately, and you know, and it's really like, you know, I'm like, well, it's kind of a fragile moment because I'm making them kind of different. And then I'm like, well, I guess it's not a fragile moment. I guess it's been released to the dogs, you know. So, but I hope it'll be okay up there. And I have them perched, kind of. I'm trying, because the soil here is so caliche that to get in there, you have to dig, and it hurts. And I can't dig that far. And so I pile up a lot of soil instead. And when the tree is more established, its roots can slither through all of that caliche, but not at the beginning. You know, they still want that nice soil. I'm making nice soil, though. I'm making a lot of nice soil. I'm doing the thing that the guy in Phoenix, the desert gardener in Phoenix, Jake, I'm doing what he's doing, where you put the whole bunch of the chips on a pile. The soil underneath, it starts to make soil underneath, and whatever soil was there also becomes enriched. So it's kind of cool. So I stole from my pile today. I got a whole bunch of goodies. But yeah, so I was doing that. I have two rosemary bushes, and I am like thrilled to have rosemary bushes because they're so fragrant. But in my plans, I have them set to the front, and I'm like, no, why would I put the fragrant rosemaries at the front? And now I'm I'm mad at myself because I have the rosemaries. Gosh dang it, because they belong there next to those little trees, and you know, to make like a pattern, they belong there, and yet I don't want to part with them, so I want to keep them back here and then put less in the front. But the whole point was to like landscape the front, you know, so it wasn't a place to people to park their car, you know, like on your lawn, because that's something they do here, or on your rocks, they like to park their cars, and they think that is, I don't know, does that give them something? I think they're just rude. I saw a sheriff car today parked on his rocks, or her rocks, or whoever's rocks they were. I mean, terrible. Terrible. You know, and they're supposed to be the sheriffs or whatever. Example here. There's an example. Park normal on the street. Don't put it on the rocks, or don't put it on the grass. Yeah, you know, so and you can say, well, that's something that seeps over from the border, you know, that they just can't be, you know, what do they say it? They can't care less. And well, that's part of the Blade Runner headed too, isn't it? You know, can't care less. And that's what's that, another regulation was given to me, and I can't care less now about that company. I don't even want to visit them now. I don't even want to use their service. I don't want to even visit their links ever again. I've become like a dissident of this. It's like a real estate company that gives you listings. I'm a dissident of them now. I don't want to visit them ever. So, yeah, I don't like another regulation. And the PayPal company does it also. They keep sending me these mails, and there's another regulation. And I'm like, well, I don't even use this service. I don't even use it. But yet they keep showing up with another one, another regulation. So, I don't know. I don't even know what I'm talking about tonight. I'm just yabbing. Oh, I had a really good news. It was not good, though. I got the electric bill down to $9. However, it wasn't really $9. I had a credits of 12, so it was only, it's like $22, but yeah, so I got the bill down to $22. And then I'm like, well, how is that good for solar if I can get the bill down to $22 and I'm here, you know, because solar is like such a cool thing, you know, you never have a bill after you have that installation, you don't have the $22 even. But the solar people aren't interested in me. I went to their site and they said no, they wanted bills that were like in the $75 or more range, so I didn't really qualify. So that's the way the solar is going. And so I'm at this 22, and I can get that even lower, but I it was at 35 or 40. It was the lights. It was the light bulbs. I changed every light bulb in the house and everyone, and reduced them to the new woo-woo lights. And well, not every. I can't say every because I have one that's really in a high place that I can't reach. And I have another two that are in a high place I can't reach. And so I always tell my dad, I said, please don't turn on that light. Please don't turn on that switch because I can't change the light up there. And I don't want to hire anybody to change it because that's stupid. Why would I want to hire somebody to change a light bulb? It's just dumb. So I don't know what to do when it goes out other than just say, hey, maybe darkness. Just leave it dark. Woo-woo. Oh, I love Rosa Ponselli lately. She's just my favorite. She's my favorite. I love her. Not lately, always, but I've just been revisiting her in my voice. I need, she has that good real reverb, a reverb flow in her tone. And that she's so on, so pure. Her notes are so pure, and she does that right there at them. She's just amazing. So I love her. I love her. She is now 1910, 1920s, really long time ago. Voice, very long time. Yeah. It's just incredible that she happened. She's like a miracle. And I know that was maybe the way the style was that they were singing, that they where their training was. Maybe there was a few others like her, but she really, really has a knack for it, doesn't she? Yeah, maybe the greatest singer ever. That we know of or we have on recording style. So any hoots. Wow. So what else did I do with it? I put in like oh, I just love plants. I put in the Japanese privet. Now, Japanese privet wasn't really supposed to get because in certain areas of the world they are invasive. The Japanese privets have a tendency to take over. So, and so do the Texarkana ones, the Texas ones. But I don't think anything really takes over here because it's so desert. I don't think so. I think it's gonna be more like, hey, made it. Yes. Anyway. Yeah. And then I planted everything bizarrely, and I probably shouldn't have done it this way, but I really fell in love with an olive tree, and I prefer an olive tree for some reason at the moment, and they didn't have any pines, and so then all of a sudden I'm like, uh-oh, now they have pines. So now I have the olive tree and the pine should be switched places, but I don't want to switch them. But so I'm going to have my big pine on the other side of the house, but it's okay. I'll survive. I'll survive. And Like, oh, did I tell you I have a hummingbird that is in a nest, a little girl, a little woman hummingbird, and she's in a little tiny nest, and it's the smallest thing. It is like even smaller than this. And she's just in there. And there was a big windstorm, and she stayed there the whole time, didn't go away, and just incredible. And she's just parked there on this. She made this place to be and lay an egg, and it's right there at the front door of the house. So it's next to the trumpet flowers. I was saying this to someone. It was next to the trumpet flowers that are blooming, like constantly. They're really, really blooming trumpet flowers. They're from the southwest, so they made a really good variety. Anyhoot. And so what's that? Yeah, the trumpet flowers. So now the little hummingbird doesn't have to do much. She just goes into the flower and back into the nest. So it's kind of a good location, isn't it? Good location. Sometimes I hate this machine. It's like a truth serum thing for me. I never lie. I need to lie. It's very much like one of those, like a truth serum. Oh, that's what I was going to talk about. It was the weirdest thing. It's not the weirdest thing. It happens often with me. But I was singing, and I had this thought, and I'm like, oh my gosh, and then if I go this direction, that's just not going to work, you know, I was thinking. And then all of a sudden the battery and one of my telephones there, the telephone was it had the battery charge, went like that, like it didn't want to, it wasn't plugged in, you know, so it ran out of the battery just at that moment. You know, the same moment that I was thinking, oh no, that's never gonna work if I head that direction, you know. And it's going here. And so I was like a real, like electricity now is hyped into my brain at the same moment. And, you know, that's not impossible, I guess, with all of this wireless. So here we have now electricity happening. The lack of electricity. Felt the lack of, I had a moment and I was thinking, no, that's a lack, that's not going to be working. So I had an electrical, like a battery fail in my brain, and the battery on the cell phone that wasn't plugged in went same time. So yeah, I mean, maybe it's just the battery in our brain, very similar, you know, because we're electrical. You're electrical people. Anyway, so I know I'm not helping much tonight. I'm not helping anything. I think we have a terrible president, and I can't fix it. I'm sorry. His name, I don't want to even hear it. I don't even want to see it. I don't want to see his face. But, he's just has an atrocious list. And I think it's just like a war that he is setting out against anybody liberal. You know, they had a war a long time ago in America. There was a civil war. And he's the type of person that is starting a civil war between Republicans and Democrats. He's starting that much of a rift and a hatred. He's not been good. It's not been good for this U.S. bonding group. It's so fractured. And in a way, I believe the fractured America is, how shall we say it? It's just conducive for war. The more fractured we are as a nation, it's more conducive for war, making war machines, blah, 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 all of that. So it pays for the what do you call them, the war? They're the war, the war machine makers, them, yeah. So it pays their bank balances, doesn't it? The more fractured we are, more mean Republican, more mean Democrat, more chance for war, Why can't we just be a nice American? Can't be. They won't. That group wants the friction, wants the meanness, wants that aggression. And it's really immature and childish to want all of that aggression, but they want it. They want that aggression. They don't care about the health that it puts you in, your health state. They don't care. If you die from it, from worrying about it or feeling attacked by it, they don't care. They're really, really, and also evil. Evil. It's an evil group that wants that much hatred between these two parties. Yeah. None of this is going on. None of this. Yes, I see your way for a moment, and I'll see your way, and no agreements. None of that's going on. It's just sick. It's just sick and childish. It's just that I've got all the toys, and that's the way it goes. Na 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 na. I got all the toys, and that's the way they are with their business of running the government right now. And I just have no respect for them at all. And I hope, actually, from this, that a lot of Republicans are just like, hey, I don't want to be Republican anymore. I can't support this guy. Maybe you'll lose a whole bunch of them. That would be good. Anyhoots. Yeah, so. Yeah, I would like the electric bill to be $9. That would be, or even less. That would be great. But here I am with my low voltage lights, my low voltage computer, and I don't even watch the television. But it's a share household, so I have to give certain things. That and I don't know, newer TVs, maybe they're better, but it's a real old one, and so I don't think it's helping. But I'm on the gas stove. Gas is very good. Gas water heater, and the gas water heater is expensive. That's the most expensive thing in the house. It's like $300 a year, and I can't change that. I asked them what it would cost to turn it into one of those hot water heater things, instant. And he's like, oh, that'll be almost $5,000. And I'm like, well, okay, we'll just forget that. So that's not happening. I'm stuck with a $300 one a year. And it's a big monolithic type of container. Nobody needs it. Nobody needs that kind of thing. It's stupid. We only need those instant ones now. The installer says he has to drill the holes in the wall. He has to put the structure of a frame. And then after all of that is done, then deal with the piping. And so they go on and on and on and on. And it's a very expensive project. So what else was, an electric bill, the hype of electric bill is going to be electrical tools for me. Anytime I use electrical tools, it'll hype that thing up. The drills, what do you call that thing? It's like a little jigsaw. And then there's another one that it's like I have an electrical, it's like one of those things that you a hedge trimmer, yeah, that type of thing. Any of those things, electric, run up the bill. And I'm not into using gas on them either, though. So I'm kind of stuck. Anytime you have to use those, then the bill's gonna go. So anyway, what else? I don't know. My dad got out of bed on the wrong side today, and he was angry as all heck, and he was calling me a whore. So it was not a good morning. And I'm like, a whore? That's a really good one. Because I'm like, well, oh my gosh, that's been a long time since I even had sex. It's a funny thing to yell at me. It was like a humor status. But not for him, you know. He just, I don't know, he just jumps at that word. Like, well, is it what I'm wearing? Is it my hair? I don't know. Oh, darn it, darn it. I think that age group and that Catholic Church, or I mean, where are the nails? I'm sorry, we can put the nails on the doors of the Catholic Church and just pound it shut forever, and nobody can go back in. That's where the nails belong. Just, that's it. Hammer the nail on those doors. Nobody allowed in Catholic Church ever again. Then all these lovely women out here don't have to be called whores. All right. Anyway, good night, Mr. and Mrs. Blade Runner. Oy, oy, oy.